Good morning, students. In the last video, I have uploaded about the development of female gametophyte. Now we are going to see what is pollen-pistil interaction. Before that, we should have a brief idea about what is pollination. It is the transfer of pollen grains from anther of one flower to the stigma of either same or different flower. For this pollination to occur, it requires various agents in cross-pollination. The various agents are air, water, insects, bats and birds. So pollination, when it occurs by air or wind, it is anemophily. By water, it is hydrophily. By insects, it is entomophily. By bats, it is chiropterophily. And by birds, it is ornithophily. These are the various types of pollination and these are the various agents. So this is how pollination takes place. This is the male part, a stamen. This is the female part, carpel. These are the pollen grains. So this is how the pollination takes place from stamen to the carpel. Now I am going to explain you what is pollen-pistil interaction. So it is an interaction which is very essential for the pistil to accept the pollen. Or it is the ability of the pistil to recognize the pollen. So it is of two types. The pollen may be a compatible type or an incompatible type. The compatible type is of right type and incompatible is of wrong type. If the compatible pollen falls on the pistil accepts the pollen and subsequently it promotes post-fertilization events. If the incompatible pollen falls on the pistil rejects the pollen and promotes the post-fertilization, so it prevents pollen germination, growth of pollen tube. So this interaction is very important for the pistil to accept the pollen. Now I am going to explain the various events leading to fertilization. So, as in the last video, we have seen what is microsporogenesis. It is a process by which pollen grains are formed. Pollen grains are formed from the male part, that is anther. When you take a cross section of the anther, this is a tetrasporangiate anther which contains pollen sacs through which pollen grains are formed. This process is known as microsporogenesis. On the other hand, the female part of the flower, that is the gynoecium, which has three parts, stigma, style and ovary. Inside the ovary, ovule is present and megaspores are formed inside the ovary. And the formation of megaspores is known as megasporogenesis. So this is the male part of the flower, this is the female part of the flower. Now, the pollen grains, how they are dispersed by air and insects and finally land on the stigma. So, the pollinating agents, here I have written few, they are by air or it may be insects. Now, this is a longitudinal section of a pistil showing pollen germination. Now, pollen grains, by the help of pollinating agents, they reach and land on the stigma. They are attached to the stigmatic surface. And this pollen grains are chemically or positively chemotropic. What does it mean? It means that the pollen tube is directed towards the ovary by chemicals. Hence, this influence is called as positively chemotropic. That means the pollen grains, the growth of the pollen grain into pollen tube is directed only towards the ovary but not through any other direction because it is influenced by the chemicals. Hence, it is called as chemotactic influence, or we can say it as positively chemotropic. This is a diagram of a longitudinal section of a pistil showing pollen germination. You see here how the pollen grains germinate. It forms a pollen tube, and this pollen tube carries two male gametes, and this is how the entry of pollen tube takes place into the ovule, into the embryo sac through the micropylar end. In the last video, I have uploaded the details of the LS or longitudinal section of ovule with the micropylar end, chalazal end, and the 7-celled 8-nucleated embryo sac. So this is how the pollen tube grows and makes its entry into the embryo sac through the micropylar end. You can take a screenshot of this, or you can draw a diagram of this by pausing the video. We'll see now how the pollen tube makes its entry into the ovule. So this is entry of pollen tube into the ovule. So there are three directions through which the pollen tube makes its entry. Now you can visualize here three diagrams. Go through it carefully. Now I have shown you the entry of pollen tube through three different directions. The first one, the pollen tube makes its entry into the ovule through the micropylar end. Hence, this pathway is known as porogamy. Number two, when the pollen tube makes its entry through the chalazal end, this is chalaza. Here from the pollen tube comes and makes its entry into the embryo sac. So this is known as chalazogamy. In the third picture, you see the pollen tube enters through the integuments. Hence, this process is known as mesogamy. So porogamy is entry of the pollen tube into the ovule through the micropyle. This is pollen tube entry through the chalaza. This is pollen tube entry into the ovule through the integuments. Okay? So these are the entry of pollen tube into the ovule. So whatever may be the direction, finally the final entry into the embryo sac occurs through the micropylar end only. So please note down this. The final entry into the embryo sac occurs only through micropyle. The other event leading to fertilization, the second event, is discharge of male gametes. So, in the previous diagram, I have shown you that the pollen tube carries two male gametes. Now, how the discharge of male gametes takes place? So, pollen tube carrying two male gametes reaches the embryo sac, where it bursts, where the pollen tube bursts and releases two sperms into the embryo sac. Now takes place the process of fertilization. Now, what is fertilization and what is fertilization in angiosperms? So, now the pollen tube has discharged two male gametes or two sperms into the embryo sac, finally leading to fertilization. Now, what is fertilization in angiosperms? As we all know, the fusion of male gamete and female gamete leading to the formation of zygote is known as fertilization. It occurs inside the embryo sac of a plant. Now, this fertilization process involves two processes. It is syngamy and triple fusion. As two processes are involved, it is called as double fertilization. This double fertilization, it is a characteristic feature of angiosperms. Now first I am going to explain you what is syngamy. Syngamy is the fusion of one sperm to fertilize the egg cell. This fusion is called as syngamy. It results in the formation of zygote, which gives rise to a proper embryo. Now what is triple fusion? Triple fusion is the fusion of the remaining sperm nuclei with two polar nuclei. The two polar nuclei present in the center of the embryo sac. The fusion of the sperm with two polar nuclei, which results in the formation of primary endosperm nucleus. So as the sperm or male gamete is haploid, two polar nuclei N plus N, it results in the formation of a triploid nucleus called primary endosperm nucleus. Okay. Now when the two polar nuclei are fused, it is otherwise called as secondary nucleus. So see, secondary nucleus is the fused state, hence it is 2N. If it is not fused, it is N plus N state. So finally, the product is a triploid product called primary endosperm nucleus, or PEN. This, on further development, gives rise to primary endosperm cell, PEC. Primary endosperm cell ultimately leads to a triploid product called endosperm. So this triploid endosperm is a characteristic feature of angiosperms only. Now what happens, or what is the role of endosperm here? Endosperm, it serves to provide nutrition to the developing embryo. So this is a very important question. What is the role of endosperm? It's a one mark question. I repeat, endosperm serves to provide nutrition to the developing embryo. So these two processes, that is syngamy and triple fusion, are the two processes involved in double fertilization. So double fertilization involves syngamy, triple fusion. And double fertilization is a characteristic feature of angiosperms, and this was first observed by Navaschin. Okay. Fertilization is by Strasburger, but double fertilization has been observed by Navaschin. Okay. Now, some important board questions related to this chapter. Discuss the process of double fertilization in angiosperms. It may be a 5-mark long answer question. Next question is, discuss the various events leading to fertilization. So, you have to describe the events leading to fertilization. Next, there is a label diagram to draw the longitudinal section of an anatropous ovule. Next, draw a label diagram of a germinating pollen grain on the stigma. Now we'll see the significance of double fertilization. It will result in the formation of viable seeds. What is viable? Viable means it has the capacity to germinate. Next significance is formation of embryo and endosperm. So as we have seen, by the syngamy, it leads to the formation of embryo. By triple fusion, there is formation of endosperm. So what is the role of endosperm here? Endosperm provides nourishment to the growing embryo. So this is the significance of double fertilization. I am going to explain you what happens after fertilization or post-fertilization events. There are some major changes, minor changes. The major changes are, ovary has changed to fruit. Ovary wall gets changed to fruit wall. Ovules gets changed to seeds. And zygote leads to the formation of embryo. And primary endosperm nucleus changes to endosperm. All these are the major changes. Next, What are the minor changes? The minor changes are, we know that the integument is protected by outer integument, inner integument. So outer integument after fertilization will change to testa of seed. This is a seed covering, outer covering of seed called testa, and the inner integument will change to tegmen. Tegmen of seed. These are the two layers of the seed. Okay. These are the post-fertilization changes. But what happens to calyx corolla? But what happens to the antipodal cells, synergids, nucellus? All these are the disorganized parts, and they remain as a thin layer of nucellus in the seed and called as perisperm. Now, what are the other changes in the calyx corolla? Stamen, style, stigma, all of them fall off. Okay? All of them fall off. So, these are the major changes. These are the minor changes which occurs after fertilization. Thank you.